The course of the facial nerve can be divided into two parts. Intracranial, the course of the nerve through the cranial cavity, and the cranium itself. Extracranial, the course of the nerve outside the cranium through the face and neck. Intracranial, the nerve arises in the pons, an area of the brainstem. It begins as two roots, a large motor root and a small sensory root. The part of the facial nerve that arises from the sensory root is sometimes known as the intermediate nerve. The two roots travel through the internal acoustic meatus, a 1 centimeter long opening in the petrose part of the temporal bone. Here, they are in very close proximity to the inner ear. Still within the temporal bone, the roots leave the internal acoustic meatus and enter into the facial canal. The canal is a Z-shaped structure. Within the facial canal, three important events occur. Firstly, the two roots fuse to form the facial nerve. Next, the nerve forms the geniculate ganglion. A ganglion is a collection of nerve cell bodies. Lastly, the nerve gives rise to greater petrosal nerve, which then supplies parasympathetic fibers to mucous glands and lacrimal gland. Nerve to stapedius, which then supplies motor fibers to stapedius muscle of the middle ear. Corda tympani, which then supplies special sensory fibers to the anterior 2/3 tongue and parasympathetic fibers to the submandibular and sublingual glands. The facial nerve then exits the facial canal and the cranium via the stylomastoid foramen. This is an exit located just posterior to the styloid process of the temporal bone. Extracranial. After exiting the skull, the first extracranial branch to arise is the posterior auricular nerve. It provides motor innervation to some of the muscles around the ear. Immediately distal to this, motor branches are sent to the posterior belly of the digastric muscle and to the stylohyoid muscle. The main trunk of the nerve, now termed the motor root of the facial nerve, continues anteriorly and inferiorly into the parotid gland. Within the parotid gland, the nerve terminates by splitting into 5 branches. Temporal branch, which supplies temporalis muscle on face. Zygomatic branch, which supplies the zygomatic arch. Buccal branch, which supplies the buccal region. Marginal mandibular branch, supplies the mandibular region. Cervical branch, supplies cervical region. These branches are responsible for innervating the muscles of facial expression.